Nova Scotia cancer rates are high, one of the highest in the country. One in two Nova Scotians will have cancer during their lifetime, and one in three will die from cancer. Just in 2021, we diagnosed about 7,000 new cancers, and it is our family members, it is our friends, our communities who are affected by it.
Basically, anyone with a cancer diagnosis faces a decision for treatment that would involve surgery or radiation or chemotherapy. We now have many more reasons to treat with radiation than we ever did before.
Of the cancer patients that are diagnosed, 50% of them would, at some point during their cancer journey, would need radiation treatment.
The very first step of any radiation planning process is in the CT sim. The new technology that we have, we're able not only to identify the tumor itself, but we're able to target it as it's moving. A great example would be a lung cancer. The lungs move. So you have to be able to target that lung cancer as the lung is moving.
They would use those images to create a treatment plan that maximizes dose to the area they want to treat while sparing all of the normal tissue. So that way there's less side effects for the patient.
The higher dose per treatment we can deliver, patients would not have to come for treatment 35, 40 times over 6 to 8 weeks. But we can deliver the same dose of radiation therapy, maybe 5 to 10 treatments or even less.
So not only does it give a better chance of cure, but it's much more convenient for patients. So it's a win-win on both of those fronts.
For CT scans, we probably do in excess of about 3,200 per year. Our current CT scanner is at capacity as far as the amount of scans that we can do per year. So we do need to increase the ability and add more capacity, which means adding a second CT scanner.
But the other important piece is redundancy. So you really need to have a backup machine. Machines go down, and if that one critical piece of machinery goes down, that would limit an ability to proceed with radiation.
If we have delays in radiation therapy, all the other pillars of cancer care will be affected as well. The emotional burden on a patient who has been diagnosed with cancer, a delay just exacerbates this.
We've been through that obviously in the COVID pandemic, and we just want to do all we can with the resources we have to decrease wait times.
Generally, a CT scanner, the life expectancy is about 10 years. If you push it 12 years, it's like your car. The more you use it, the shorter the lifespan. Our current one is getting close to 10 years. And to be able to have the QEII Foundation donors help bring that to fruition, meaning that we'll have two current, most efficient and up-to-date models. That is great.
I would always want, you know, my family, anyone else's family, to get the state-of-the-art treatments that they'd get anywhere else in the world, and we can offer that in Halifax.
Here in Nova Scotia, the care that we provide for our cancer patients is second to none, world class. And that's all the generous donors or the QEII Foundation.
I wanted to say a deep and heartfelt thank you to QEII Foundation donors. This life-changing gift will result in better outcomes.
I would say thank you. Your donation is going to impact each and every cancer patient walking into our radiotherapy center. This one piece of equipment is that piece that will touch so many patients and so many families.